Warning. The show you're about to see contains material unsuitable for children and questionable among most adults. Viewer discretion is advised.
No, it's terrible. Her tongue cut in half. I mean, I know when she's a baby, she can't not move it. Was there anything they can do? Can they put it under? Allergies, yeah. No, go ahead. Uh-huh. Oh my God, no. I think they should bury her, yeah. I don't think you cremate a baby, right? I don't think you cremate a baby. I'm so sorry. I'll call you right back. I just have an important meeting right now. Okay. Yeah, take care. Sorry about your baby. Bye. I'm so sorry. That's so rude.
Oh, that's okay. You want to take a look at the...
You know what? I'm waiting for someone.
Okay.
My fiancé. Okay.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
So I'll be back.
I never thought that at my age, you know, I'd be getting married.
So give you a few seconds to...
Yeah, okay, great. I mean, I've known this guy a long time. Well, not a long time, a few months.
But we're waiting on him. We're waiting on him?
Yes.
Okay, all right. Great. Okay.
I remember when I first met him. We used to, we would meet in this diner, or he would come to this diner and I would be there just, you know, at the counter having my Merlot, and he'd come in and I saw him and I thought, oh, that's the one. So I went up to him and I tapped him on the shoulder and I said, excuse me, but I think you are gorgeous and I would like to date you. And he said, ew. And then the next day, he came in again, and I did the very same thing. I went up and I said, excuse me, again, my name is Joyce. I would like to date you. And he said, ew. And then that happened again, and again, and again, and again, until finally, one night, wouldn't you know, he comes in sobbing. And he is just distraught beside himself. And I hate my life. I want to die. The world is over. And I thought, here's my chance. And so I walk up and I say, excuse me.
Yeah.
My name is Joyce.
Joyce, yeah.
And I would like to date you. And we have been seeing each other ever since.
And that's nice.
Thank you.
Okay, yeah. So I'm gonna come back in a little bit.
Okay.
Right.
Well, thank you. Mm-hmm. Oh, excuse me. I just have a question.
Sure.
Salads.
Salads.
I didn't know what that word was.
Yeah.
I don't know where he is.
But you don't want to order yet?
No, I'm waiting. I'm waiting for John. He's late. John. There he is.
Oh, okay. Welcome.
John, you're late.
I'm sorry.
So, may I interest you in the joke of the week?
Well, I'd like to know what it is.
Sure. Okay. The joke of the week is being in the hospital is like being with a very expensive hooker. It's $1,000 a night, and when you wake up, your gallbladder is missing.
I think just water. Okay. Thank you.
Should I read you the specials?
Sure.
Okay, so we have garlic nibblers on a creamy white sauce. Mm. These are served in a bed of iceberg lettuce.
Okay.
It's served warm for the most part.
Okay. They're nibblers. Mm-hmm. So about how big?
Just like
a nibble size.
Just like standard nibble size?
Yeah.
So like
how many fit on a plate, if that's...
Don't touch the plate, then.
I guess our plate is maybe 2.5 nibblers.
2.5 nibblers.
Yeah. Huh. So we have the nibblers, and we also have tortellini Alfredo in a clam water. Mm. And also, we have a Venetian cutlet sampler.
Oh.
It's the whole thing's breaded, and the cutlets are positioned so they form a fan.
So it's a whole array of cutlets.
It's a whole array of cutlets.
Oh, it's been so long since I've had an array of cutlets.
So would you like the...
No, none of those. Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah, we just need a minute with the menu.
Sure, I'm sorry.
The menu.
Yeah. Okay, all right. I'll be back to take your order.
Okay.
All right.
I think maybe take a look at this, but we do have the plans to discuss, okay?
Yep, let me order first.
Okay.
How are you?
I'm okay. My rib feels weird.
Does it hurt? Is it?
No, it's not that it hurts. It's just sort of it feels like it doesn't belong. How was your how was your day, huh?
It's good. I did a little writing in the park.
I think it's so cute that you write.
I mean, it's just what I do.
Right. Yeah. Oh, I've been pretty busy myself. I got I got that job at the greeting card company, and they want 5 pitches from me, so I had to come up with 5.
I mean, it's...
Do you want to hear what the pitches are?
Well, let me just figure out what I want. I like this prime rib.
Prime rib?
8-ounce prime rib, slow roasted in rock salt.
Uh-huh.
Served au jus.
Uh-huh. Au jus, what's that?
I don't know, I'll ask the waiter.
What?
I'll ask the waiter.
Okay. You mumble.
Yep.
You mumble. Balsamic. Ooh. Oven roasted. Oh, I love the way these words make everything seem so appetizing. I'd really like to read you my pitches.
All right, fine. Read the pitches.
Okay, so now this is a big deal. Okay, so I need your full attention and support.
I'm paying attention. Okay, I'm staring in the eyes.
Now. Picture a greeting card, okay? It's embossed, and it's got a farm, and one of those little,
Ferris wheel.
No, a mill. It's got one of those water mills, you know, mm-hmm. that spins?
Yep.
And then on the inside, it's sorry about your foot.
Seems specific.
Well, that's the thing, is I'm coming up with greeting cards for occasions that, you know, they haven't already thought of. Because Hallmark does, you know, happy birthday, happy Father's Day. I want to make cards that people need, you know. Things happen to people in life, and they go to the card section, and they don't have any choices. Let me read you the other ones. So... There's a card, and there's just rows and rows of pink teddy bears, right? But in second to last row, maybe 2 or 3 bears in, not right in the center, just a little off, there's one blue bear, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you open it up, on the inside it says, any updates on how Dad's doing? All right, number 3. There's a, I love this one. Imagine a big fuzzy peach and it's scratch and sniff, right? Mm-hmm. And then on the inside it says, I'm taking legal action.
What's the smell?
Peach! You're so cute! Oh. Okay, the fourth card, a silver cross with a gold dove just off the side of it, you know? Mm-hmm. And you open it, and it's a beautiful card. And you open it, and it says, we sold the house. It's for, you know, like...
Selling what a house.
Yeah, Christians in real estate. There's not a lot for them. Okay, you're going to love this one. Uh-huh. This is the last one. I think this is the winner, too. I saved it for last. An American flag waving in the wind. But one of the stars is on fire. Okay? Mm-hmm. Then underneath that flag is a little boy. And he's carrying a basket. And he looks hopeless. He looks done in. And he's walking towards the Grim Reaper. And the Grim Reaper is standing there, and a tear is coming down his face because he doesn't want to take this boy, and this boy doesn't want to go. And then it's just blank inside. Yeah. You're the wrong audience for this. You're a little biased because you like me.
That's right.
So, what were you writing today
Nothing.
In the park? Oh, come on, tell me.
No, it's just a work in progress.
Well, I am a good I love your work, and I love progress.
But this is more personal work
for
me.
Oh, come on. Come on. Come on. Tell Joyce. Tell Joyce.
All right. I don't know. I don't think you'll like it, frankly.
Oh, maybe I won't, but, you know.
It's referencing things that I don't know if you... Date, January 13th. Time, 1900 hours.
Ooh, I love it.
Don't interrupt me. Setting, the Korean War. It was a long day at the 4077. Unit Captain John Diesel was new on the job, and replacing Hawkeye Pierce was no easy task, both in the surgery room and elsewhere on the base. But camaraderie was the furthest thing from his mind. An unexpected barrage of shellfire caused the medic truck to overturn, and one of them inside was Major Margaret Houlihan, who the guys called Hot Lips. Quill had heard she had a broken heart after Hawkeye left, but this was entirely different. She had been hit in the upper thigh with shell casing. Luckily, Diesel was an extremely skilled surgeon. He was also a poet. He had been affectionately nicknamed Quill around the base due to his constant solitary poetry writing. Later that night, Potter, Klinger, and Honeycutt, and Winchester were all in the officers' club enjoying Nurse Kelly's ukulele. But Quill was sitting alone. He couldn't get Hot Lips Houlihan off his mind, and he decided to go check on her. "Where are you going, Quill?" the wry Honeycutt asked. "To give Hot Lips my book of poetry." A smiling Quill walked into the recovery tent and placed his gentle hand on her shoulder and asked her how she was feeling. "Okay, now that I have a wonderful doctor like you," Houlihan whispered. She gently placed her hand on top of Quill's and looked at him with starry eyes. Quill was smitten. Maybe it was the alcohol, maybe the chaos of war, but something came over Quill and he kissed her passionately on the lips. Houlihan was startled, but she tightened her grip on Gentle's hand and she begun tonguing him thoroughly. Moving a curtain to make sure that no other patients would be disturbed, Gentle stripped off her clothes and took a moment to stare at her perfect naked body. It didn't take long for me to realize why they called her Hot Lips as I began pumping my fingers in and out of her sapping wet vagina. I peeled my clothes off my wet skin and she began licking my stiffy like she was cleaning off a hot wing. I pressed my tongue so deep into the slit of a gash, it felt like I was trying to clog a crack in the Hoover Dam. She begged for my stone-hard dick, so I gave it to her. I thrusted and thrusted my rod into her insides, and I took the cold stethoscope and shoved it right into a bullet wound so I could finally hear what a climax sounded like from the insides. Everybody at the 4077 was awoken by my screams. Me and Loretta Swit fell asleep with our naked arms in a lover's embrace. Next morning, Quill went to sit by himself, but was quickly joined by Klinger, Honeycutt, and Winchester. Can I help you fellows? Quill asked nonchalantly. Yeah, can I borrow that poetry book of yours when Houlihan is done with it?
Is that a new hat?
Yes. I got it at the Salvation Army today.
Oh, I like it. I have a couple of questions about what you wrote.
Uh-huh.
Gash?
Vagina.
Okay.
It's like Bukowski, you know? You challenge people with their expectations, with their personal limits. Maybe you push them over to the edge a little bit.
Right. I just felt sick to my stomach.
Uh-huh. That's your opinion.
Well, I think we better not talk about it, you know.
Waiter? Hi. Hi. I'm ready. Yes.
Great.
Yes.
What will the lady have?
I will have, I like you. I will have the steak, medium rare.
Okay. A steak, medium rare. Mm-hmm. And what would you like? And
I think I'll have the prime rib. The noodles. Just a plate of noodles.
Cold? The prime rib.
No, the noodle. You will have the noodles.
I have the noodles every day. I don't want the noodles today.
Well, when you can pay for the prime rib, then you can have the prime rib. But I'm paying, and you're going to have noodles.
Okay.
So steak and noodles. Great.
Yes.
Yep.
Great. And you can cook them all the way or not. It doesn't matter.
Okay. Just great.
Cook them all the way.
Great. So all the way or not, doesn't matter.
Soft. Doesn't matter.
Soft noodles.
Okay. Great. I'll be right back with your order.
Thank you so much.
And we also have a Bergen Sunset drink special.
Yes, two of those, please.
Two of those. Okay, great.
Did you just order a drink for me?
I need a drink.
I think we better just discuss the plans, okay? Now.
You hear about the flowers?
Yes, I heard about the flowers. They can do twice the amount of orange roses, because I want more. I'm not going to do a mix of colors, so I just said better get, you know.
Whatever you want.
Two times as much as the orange. What is whatever I want, because I'm paying for it.
Yes.
And now the pig.
Mm-hmm.
I want to do a whole pig, but the price that they quoted me was just outrageous. They're trying to gouge me on this pig.
Forget the pig.
Well, now hear me out. I called them today, and they said they could do a half pig.
Mm-hmm.
But it's the bottom half. And that is cheaper. So what I asked is, could I do the middle third? And they have to talk to management or something, but they're going to call me back about that tomorrow. Now, as far as what we are wearing, I do not want us to match.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
I was just going to wear, come in.
I think what you I should dress
wear.
Up.
I was going to add a tie.
Do you know how to tie a tie?
I know how to tie a tie.
Really?
I just don't wear them.
Okay. Okay.
You're slurping.
And what?
You're slurping. I think a band's about to begin.
So great. beautiful.
The apple that never sleeps.
Ground zero, right there.
I feel like anything could happen here.
You just take it to Broadway.
I wish.
Made in America, gangs in New York. Live from New York. Seagull.
Did you get that?
Did you get the bird?
You should get the birds in the
shot. Get that bird.
So it's like freedom, opportunity. They'll be back.
You
should probably head out soon, though, because the ice is moving in. We don't want another Titanic on our hands.
How did you guys meet?
I was working at the tire store, and up comes this guy in, like, a nice truck, lowers the window, and I'm like, who's this, like, Hollywood-looking guy? I get, like, I don't know, choked up. Like, I don't know what to say.
I said, are you going to kiss me? And I said, guess what? Because you were already there. I got out of the car.
And we kissed.
How long have you guys been together for?
Since we were teenagers.
Since teen.
Let's go to New York City. How do we get there?
Take the bus.
Just wait for it?
You're in New York City.
We have to get to New York City.
Yeah.
You're in New York City.
We're in Brooklyn.
We're in Brooklyn.
Yeah, Brooklyn's part of New York.
Yes,
state. But we have to get to New York City. Is that a model? Is that a mom? It's this one.
Yeah, this is the bus. We gotta get it. Oh no, that's a Spanish bus.
No!
We're trying to get on that bus! Oh, it's because he didn't stop because we didn't hold our hands out.
It's got money on it though.
Maybe it's just broken.
It's full.
Happy.
Ladies and gentlemen, Times Square.
What?
Next stop.
We got the wrong square.
Fuck! Why didn't you say anything? We're off Broadway and we're way off Broadway and we're probably miles from the nearest M&M.
So how do we get? We're in this map, but we need to get into the other map.
I'm honestly gonna throw up. Is it Times Square? Or is it Times Square?
There are three S's in total.
You getting that one? Look at the one going up the stairs. It's great.
Chesta!
What are you doing?
You gotta get on.
No. Okay.
Where am I gonna?
I couldn't think of a place.
You okay?
Jazz was like a fairy tale romance. I never thought that I would ever meet somebody like him or that somebody like him would like someone like me. He's everything that I'm not, and he makes me a better person.
I'm just gonna wait for her here. You guys have time?
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm sorry. No.
Fine.
They're my sister text messaging me. I said, don't send me. I don't know how to respond. But they're gonna cremate the baby. Which I think is a mistake, you know? Because what do you end up with about that much ash? What do you do with that?
I don't think it's about that.
What?
I don't think it's about that.
Okay. She's my sister. And she hasn't had it easy. She really hasn't. You know, well, the whole family's had a hard knocks, you know, one after another after another. My first husband fell into a toaster oven that was open.
It fell into, how big was the toaster oven?
Just a little thing. But it was on the, it was on our honeymoon, and you know, it was first time either of us had been to Wisconsin, so we were excited. He wasn't looking where he was going, and he,
I've never been.
I've never been back. But, he turned to say, Joyce, they got a toaster oven! And as he was turning, he fell, and, right, his arm right into it. And he said, ow! And as he turned with his arm, which was on fire, his elbow knocked open the door of the fridge, causing him to lose his balance. And he fell into the fridge, door slammed shut behind him, and whole thing went up in flames. He he suffocated on the smoke inside that fridge. And then I got married again.
Mm-hmm.
And he was deported. So I got married again. And he was deported.
Were they friends?
They were father and son. Then I got married again. Deported.
A third?
The mom. And, this was right when my son was institutionalized.
I thought he was in prison.
No. They wanted to send him to prison, but they didn't have enough evidence to go off of. You know, they found the girl, they found her body, they didn't find a hammer.
Mm-hmm.
They found the goat, but that wasn't enough to go off of. They got a goat and a dead body. They couldn't pin it on him. But he broke down, and he was broken. So he's been in the institution. People used to say to me, you know, did you drop him on his head or something? And I'd say no, but that's how we lost his sister. But you know, life goes on, right?
Cool.
Oh, here you go.
Nom, nom, nom. Oh, with mashed potatoes.
Enjoy.
Thank you so much. Oh, question.
Yes. Mhm. Is there something wrong?
No, I just wanted to be near you for another second longer.
Is this enough?
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
Isn't he fun? You're using your salad knife.
Oh, sorry.
Starting, outer knife sorry. Is for salad. This is for noodles. Oh, God.
Now, Dodge, what are you doing?
I don't want to put it down on the nice tablecloth.
It doesn't need to. The Dodge Poetry Festival is coming up.
The what?
The Dodge Poetry Festival. I've been mentioning it to you. You know, it's sort of where I...
No, you have it.
I do. I set up my table. Uh-huh. And I sell, you know, the books I'm publishing. You know, I did, obviously didn't...
I love that you call them books.
They're books. What do you? How do you define a book? 20 pages? 30 pages? Because mine's 50.
Well, I just... I think of books as something people actually read. God, this is so tough!
What do you mean by that?
Huh?
What do you mean by that?
I meant it was just hard to cut through.
No, what do you mean about the books?
What? I'm sorry.
You said people don't read my book. I have a...
I never said that.
I have a lot of readers.
I said I think
all of my
books
students,
as something
all
people
of my
read.
Students used to read my books. It would be on the syllabus, and at the end of the semester, they would say, John, we loved your poems.
Well, I just think that's great.
You're doing a tribute to Amiri Baraka?
A what?
A tribute to Amiri Baraka.
Who's she?
It's a he. And it's, I don't know. I don't think I even told you the story. All right, so Dodge Poetry Festival 2008. All right?
Uh-huh.
And I'm driving in, mm-hmm. and I am by the Morristown train station getting some Dunkin' Donuts.
Uh-huh.
And who do I see coming off a train from New York but Amiri Baraka? Okay? So I say, Amiri, Amiri, and I call him over. And
yeah.
He comes and sits down. It's about a 10-minute drive to the park.
Uh-huh.
But in that time, you know, he gives me a little piece of advice, and then... He gets out of the car, and a piece of paper falls out. I didn't see it until later. I sit at my table, and I do my thing. I sell some books. He comes, or I come back to the car, okay?
Okay.
And I see this little piece of paper, and I take it, and it's part of a poem by Amiri Baraka. And I said, well, you know what? Someday I'm going to see him again.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to give him the poem, and I'm going to say, I found...
You left it in my car.
Sure. And he died. He died a few years ago. And
do you think it had anything to do with the leaving the poem in your car?
I don't think so.
But, well, then what's the?
Well, here's the thing. I decided to finish the poem for him. Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna read it to you, okay? And if you think people don't like my poetry, then get a load of this. Okay.
I would love to be corrected.
All right.
Okay.
So this is a poem by Amiri Baraka and Jan Genel.
That's the one he left in your car.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, how neat.
A closed window looks down on a dirty courtyard, and black people call across a scream or walk across, defying physics in the stream of their will. We are beautiful people with African imaginations full of masks and dances and swelling voices. With African eyes and noses and arms, though we sprawl in gray chains in a space full of winters, what we want is sun. This blinding sun is as hot as a sauna. Take me back to that gal in Botswana. Who danced like an African Mata Hari with curves more beautiful than any safari. I cannot sleep, my dreams are relentless of Amaka Amaka, my Nubian empress.
That was the poem?
That was the poem, yeah.
I want to... Oh, sorry!
No, don't clean it up with that!
Hey!
It's really important to me. Oh, the words are...
I'm sorry!
Watch it!
I didn't love it.
Well, you're not a poet. I am.
Excuse me? I actually get paid for what I write.
Little greeting cards?
Yes, well, the greeting cards.
Not poetry.
They are too poetry.
It's
They're
garbage.
People's poetry.
Oh, people's poetry, yeah.
I am the Princess Diana of poets. And you know it.
What does that even mean?
It means I'm the people's poet. I reach the people. You just scribble on a little piece of paper like this without anyone looking. Ugh. You can have that.
Yes. This was a mistake.
Excuse me?
Said the band's coming up.
Day was hard because even though you guys gave me $100, I blew it on carousel and milkshakes. But it was hard because I figured Jana wasn't coming back. But she is coming back. I've been like going around meeting people. Sometimes I'll do like juggling. I'll get in on that. Meet some jugglers. A lot of fishing for scraps in the trash.
These pictures are like the only thing I got right now. And I just kind of look at these when I'm feeling lost.
Why don't you just go back to your cousin's house?
Because it's gotta be a mile away. I straight up do not have the amount of energy to make it across a bridge.
How long are you gonna stay here?
How many days have it been? 28, 29?
It's been 7.
Cool thing is, like, basically I've met every type of walk of life. Met a white guy, met a Mexican child, and his parents, and like a rich lady, and what are you guys doing? What do you guys see?
Oh, shit! Move it, quick! Move!
I've missed you!
Blood!
I've missed you!
What are you doing here?
I was following the itinerary.
The New York itinerary?
Yeah, the one that we made about all the places that we were gonna go. I thought you would be there.
I don't remember how that is.
I went to see the Empire State Building.
Yeah, the building.
I went in front of the Opera House.
Did you hear it?
Barely. I saw the Elvis Eminem.
Oh.
And then I went to the bar from the movie with Tyra Banks.
You did it all.
Yeah, well, I thought that you would meet me there eventually. I didn't know how to get a hold of you. You don't have a phone.
I mean, I would have liked to get Eminem.
I'm sorry. Go to the M&M store later.
Really tired.
Appuccino.
What? Don't do this.
Appuccino, devil's avocado, appuccino. Come here. What is it?
Make noises.
It's always that. Huh? Everybody's Chinese. Everybody.
Don't film him. It's a man named Kimchi. He comes by about this time every day. He stole my kimchi one time that I found in the trash. I feel weird when he touches me. I get itchy and bruised and...
What?
Kimchi stole my wallet. I don't have any money. Just an Arab bread card, my ID, and the pictures from the photo booth. Fucking kimchi! First pictures we took her in that wallet. My ass too tired.
I know I saw him around here somewhere. Son of a bitch!
Oh. Give me two, Obama! I can't see the Chinese!
I got him.
Take a look at this shit. This is us in Kissimmee, Florida. At the Barracuda, drunk off our asses. I was drunk, she was just having fun. Did you get it?
What?
There's one thing on the itinerary that we didn't do yet.
Yeah? Well, tell me what
it
is.
You gotta go home and do it.
I was in love. She made wheat thins. I was in love!
The problem is, it all comes up at once. I should have cooked it.
Oh, sweetie, I can then. But I can cut them for you.
I shouldn't have to cut the noodles. I should.
I'd offer you some of my steak, but I might want it later.
Guess who?
Ugh. Hi, Arthur.
Surprise, John.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi. I'm Joyce.
Joyce, hello. Nice. I'm Arthur.
Arthur. And
I'm Barbara.
Barbara, good to meet you.
We saw you here and thought to ourselves we had to go over because we had to.
We saw you with a woman and we thought, what a scandal.
Yeah,
huh?
You're usually alone. You're usually by yourself.
Oh, yes, always alone, huh?
This is Joyce. Yeah.
Oh. Joyce, hello.
Hi,
hello.
Are you friends of his? Or?
No. Oh, well, we used to work together at the school before John was dismissed.
I still work at the school.
Oh, you're the man I make the checks out
to. That's right. For John's
tuition. I pay
tuition.
For his classes. Yeah.
Well, yeah. I'm not a student. I'm a teacher's assistant. I teach assist there.
That's John, forever enrolled.
Oh. So did you meet Joyce in class? Joyce, right? That's your name?
Yeah. Oh. I'm too old to be a student. Oh.
So is John.
Oh, your friends are so fun. Should I make a check out to you now for his next semester?
No, it's we don't do business on the weekends.
Oh, okay. Neither does he. He doesn't do any business.
Nothing on the weekends, nothing on the weeknights.
No.
Just alone. In diners.
That's actually where we met.
Oh, you met at the TikTok?
You haven't changed a bit.
I was drinking a Merlot. And, well, to cut a long story short, we're engaged.
You're engaged?
To each other.
Yeah.
Oh,
wow. You know, it's funny you're engaged because he was just engaged to be married to Rose, which I'm sure you know.
He proposed.
Can we not talk
to
about
Rose?
This right
I'm
now?
I'm sure you know about Rose. He's told you about
I
Rose.
I don't know about Rose. Why don't you tell me about Rose, Barbara?
There's nothing to tell.
Oh, you don't want to talk about how there was a big proposal where you invited her and surprised her with everyone from the faculty that you could get to do this for you, lip-syncing a big song about how you wanted her to marry you. You even contacted her parents on Facebook illegally and got them to come there to watch this betrothal that you arranged. And it all fell apart before your eyes, like usual.
Well, that's our John.
Yes. In all the years that I've known you, you've never changed.
When did this happen?
Forever ago.
Oh, I'd say...
This summer.
Yeah, beginning of summer around, yeah.
That's funny, because that's exactly around when we got engaged.
John. Couldn't rebound, keep your John. Fingers out the honeypot.
Oh, he can't, Kenny.
No.
He can't.
No.
Thanks for stepping by.
Oh, John. It's always so.
Yeah, we have some arrangements to discuss.
Mm-hmm. Arrangements for
yes.
the wedding?
Let's. No,
no,
not a wedding.
Not necessarily.
It's not a wedding.
I thought you were getting married.
Well, it's a. We are, in
we're
a sense.
We're going to be engaged until whenever.
Right.
So you're
sounds
just...
like John.
it's a what did we call it? What was that term? A conscious, unconscious
no,
thing?
No, that's what you together. Called it. I called it an eternal autumn.
Eternal autumn. Okay, well, I guess that's...
but it's important. It's not important. Wait, it's wait. Not important.
What's an unconscious...
Thank you for stopping by, guys. Thank you for bringing up those the fun stories
it
that you brought up.
It doesn't matter what
you're
we
welcome.
Call it. We're going to be dead anyway.
we all die, don't we?
Yes, eventually.
But we are gonna die. Don't be ashamed. We're gonna die together. We're gonna kill ourselves together. So we're just getting the final arrangements together.
Well, we
for
always
that.
Knew
oh my
John.
God.
We always knew John would kill himself.
Yes.
But we always thought he would be alone.
Like
so
everything else.
No. So no, really. What so are these? What are alone. These arrangements for? You've piqued my interest.
We're really going to kill ourselves together.
Like, wait.
He hasn't told you? I sent out announcements.
No, I don't.
I gave you money to send out announcements.
Well, I'm not going to send out announcements about this.
Wait.
I didn't
John.
Have anybody to send
John.
Them to. It's fine.
John, are you suicidal?
I mean, more so than usual.
Oh, stop it.
Like, are you actually
Barbara.
Suicidal? Well, he's...
I know. But John.
I want to kill myself.
John,
it's practically this guy's alarm clock.
John. Mm-hmm. You don't have to do this, John. I can't even... John. I know we tease you, but we don't want you to die. That's horrible.
Too little, too late.
Yeah, besides... If he doesn't die and I die, then who's going to pay for him to live?
You've got to be joking.
I think we should go, Arthur. We have our own arrangements to make.
I don't want...
We're going to Florence, after all.
There she goes.
Oh, Florence!
Yes.
Is that in Wisconsin?
Europe, darling.
Yes. Italy.
You should go.
Yeah, I think you should go.
I guess this is it.
Well, goodbye, John.
Goodbye, John.
Goodbye. Thanks.
God, they're a little off, aren't they? So, I think we should talk about the pig. Because if
you know, what can we do without the pig? Can we just do
I
it?
I want to have at least the middle third of the pig.
For who? You're not going to have any. Hey, waiter.
Hi.
Yeah.
Can I get a...
Yeah, we need
can
the...
I refills?
Sure.
Hold on there.
You've been on your feet all day. I want you to sit down and...
Oh, that's okay.
No.
Oh, no, that's okay.
I have a little
just song. Fill these up, please.
I want to sing for you.
It's not the time or place to sing. This isn't the rec room.
If I want to sing, I'm going to fucking sing.
I'm going to have to pick that up.
Make a fool out of yourself.
No. I'll
go
get
ahead.
It. I'll
make
get
a
it.
Fool
I'll
out of yourself. Oh, you're in for a great show. Yeah? Every 7. Every night at 7.
This is an old song, but one that rings true even today. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. Next year, all our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. Next year, all our troubles will be miles away. Here we are, as in olden days.
Yeah.
Happy golden really days.
It's September.
Of your faithful friends who were near to us.
She leaves lights up all year.
Will be dear to us.
I don't think he likes that. I don't like that.
Through the years, we all will be together. If the fates allow.
Sorry for smelling like garlic nibblers.
Hang a shining star upon the highest bough. And have yourself a merry little Christmas.
All right, you've kissed the waiter. Time to go.
Well,
and if I'm not mistaken, the waiter and I would like a little more than a Christmas kiss.
Do you want the check, or?
Oh, I'll take the check.
Bring the check, please.
Take anything you have to give us.
More drinks, you said.
More drinks.
Yeah.
More drinks is a great idea. Why don't you take a walk? Why don't you take a fucking seat?
Why don't you give us a
walk? Got it.
All right. You're embarrassing me.
Oh,
I'm the one that's singing. I'm the one that's kissing the waiter, smelling the waiter.
We were having a moment.
Oh.
And you just couldn't resist just jabbing at me and jabbing at me.
All you've been doing tonight is jabbing at me. You've been making fun of my poems. You even used one as a napkin. That thing was very important to me. But no. All you care about is yourself, your greeting cards. Oh, and now you cry. Now I'm the one screaming. I have to be the bad guy all the time.
You are the bad guy. You're a bad, bad man.
I'm not a bad man. I'm a very good man.
No, you're not. I've done nothing but try to take care of you. I bought you noodles. I lend you my car.
Take these noodles.
I don't want your noodles. It's not about the noodles. I'm trying to help you, okay?
Help me with what?
We shared a bond, okay?
Barely.
Give me your hand,
no.
Please.
All we shared was two people that wanted to get off this earth, but you had to go and make it a spectacle, okay?
Because I want it to be special. I've had a hard life, okay? I've had husbands deported.
Yeah.
And one wife.
I've had a daughter that died. I had a son that's institutionalized.
Well, I'm sorry that you had the opportunity. I'm sorry you had the opportunity to have a family and you failed. I've never had that opportunity.
Because you push people away. I've had people leave me, okay? And it's not my fault. You don't have it in you. Thank you so much. You don't have it in you to care about anyone but yourself.
And here's the check.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
You know, that's
you're not
that's
capable.
Tough talk.
You're not capable. You don't have it in you.
I'm not as selfish as you are, okay?
Selfish.
I am very in touch with my emotions.
Selfish.
And you just go gallivanting around being a spectacle. Everything is a spectacle. Everything needs the right flowers. Everything needs the right part of the pig. You know what? You're a pig. You're a greedy little pig, greedy for attention.
I've had a hard life, but I've made the best of it. And I just wanted one thing to go right. My death. I wanted to kill myself on my own terms, and I wanted it to have it nice. And I wanted it to spend it with someone I thought shared the same views as me. You're not the man I met at that diner. You don't care about me. I'm gonna kill myself on my own. You don't deserve me. You don't even deserve to kill yourself. And have yourself a merry little Christmas.
How are we doing on the check? Is it ready?
Yeah.
Great, thank you. Oh, it's, did you drop your card, maybe?
I don't have a card.
Oh, we take cash. Do you need a minute?
I don't have cash.
Is there a question about the check?
I don't have any questions about the check. She had all the money and she left.
Okay. So how do you want to pay?
I guess I'll go in the back and do dishes.
That's like a cartoon thing. We don't do that. We
can't just go in the back.
No, there's a machine. There's a machine that someone made and provided, and we gave them money in exchange for a service.
How it works.
Like, not to be vulgar, but I leave off tips, and you know the world revolves with like money. Then, so how do you want to?
I don't know. Whatever you gotta do.
Well, we'll stop eating, or that's, okay. Well, I guess I'm gonna call the police. Okay.
Oh, that's another chapter. I don't think I'll do too well in prison. Hey.